Felix Mapunga Photography.
It is a shame that fellow Africans are killing each other in the name of ignorance because we don't know who we are. I've said this a number of times in the past. I must say it again because xenophobia has erupted again in South Africa. If you look around your own country here in South Africa, you have the Mlochoas, you have the Bebes, you have the Msimangas, you have the Ngumalos, the Ndwandwes, the Fakudes, the Mtolos, the Skosanas, and all these tribes that are in the Bunganes, the Kosas, the Mahlubis, Swazis, Sutus, Pedis, Shanganis, and Vendors. Now let's just maybe look at one or two or three of those things so that we can add value to our understanding as Africans. We must keep on talking until we all understand. Number one, if you understand that African totems are linked to animals, there's no reason why we must be killing each other, particularly as Africans. It only says that we don't understand exactly who we are as Africans. If you can go to Kenya and Tanzania, and you find someone who says, I am from the fish, the tribe of the fish. You come to South Africa, Kibaka Kapi. You go to Zimbabwe, Dogwa Hobe. You go to, which part of that can be more complicated, except that we understand that all these tribes are connected. You cannot tell me that an elephant in Kenya and in Nigeria is a different animal when you come to South Africa. Undlovu, Ukacheni, it's the same thing. Ubanda. Usibanda, it's the same thing. Shoko, Mukanya, Vudjena, Kabo, it's the same thing. So we need as Africans to start learning that our connection to each other is not only linked in terms of our languages, but our totemic connections to our tribal animalistic that connects us deeper as Africans than anything else. So forget about your language. Forget about your passports, which these Afrikaners and Europeans came here to give us these passports that demarcate us into small little columns of meaninglessness. Our real passport must be an African passport. We all belong to this continent. We need our governments to stop lying and telling us stories of how budgets and what. There is enough resources in Africa for every African child that is on the ground. We don't need to kill each other. There's enough diamonds in Africa, enough tantalite, enough chrome, enough zinc, enough manganesium, enough gold, enough oil for ourselves, copper, enough food for ourselves in Africa. There's no need, enough sea and fish. People cannot be bad like goats. You can't. People must move where they want to move to, live where they want to live, particularly if they are Africans. And for that reason, I say xenophobia, it can only be informed by the misconception of those that have been colonized. Unless and until you understand that to be an African is not a passport, to be an African is to be humankind, to be mankind. When you see another person that looks like you, like this, that person belongs here. Whether they're in America, they're in China, they're in Indonesia, they're in Asia, does not matter. If you see them with the same complexion, they belong right here. And no African must touch another African because these are our blood relatives. We cannot live in Europe and we're called illegal immigrants. We go to America, we're called aliens. As if we don't have a country for our own. There's only one place we are going to be calling home, and that home is Africa. So Africa is for Africans, not only Africans. It's for Black American Africans, it's for Aboriginal Africans, for those Africans that are in the islands, for the Africans that are in Asia and everywhere else. As long as you see someone that looks like you, that person belongs here to the mother continent. That's Ubuntu Nation. That's Ubuntu Nation. That's what I stand for.